Incubus' fame was rising. Make Yourself had gone platinum, and the band's follow-up, Morning View, would be the pinnacle of their success. Huge hits, and the occasional sounds like a McDonald's commercial track, Morning View sent the band sky high. Now regular guests on MTV and performing on late night shows, Incubus had a rabid pop music fan base. A fan base that had expectations and felt they knew what the band's sound was. After parting ways with their bass player, the band released A Crow Left of the Murder. In true Incubus fashion, they reinvented their sound, which was not a great thing for those fans who were expecting more of the same. Being familiar with the progression of the band, I had a bit of an edge. I knew the one thing you should go into any new Incubus album knowing: expect the unexpected. I was pleased with the sound. Continuing their downward trend on the Billboard charts, the release of Light Grenades would be another point of contention with the fans. Although they were having some commercial success with the album, the fans weren't particularly happy with the choice to continue with the sound that they created on Crow Left of the Murder. That album had gone platinum along with Morning View and Make Yourself, but Like Grenades was struggling to get gold. It was the end of an era. Erica. 5 years later, the band would return with If Not Now, When? Probably the band's most underrated album due to the fact that people largely hadn't liked previous albums, and that it had been a while since Incubus had released anything. The album was well thought out and seemed meticulously pieced together. I thought it was absolutely beautiful. Four years later, in 2015, the band released Trust Fall Side A, a departure from their previous sound yet again. This time, I was the victim. While I could appreciate some tracks on the album, the bulk of the music seemed like it was a complete opposite of the intricate If Not Now, When album. It just felt sloppy to me. Cringe parts and melodies that almost felt intentional. Two years later, the band would release 8, an album that would further distance me from understanding what it was the band was aiming for. Now they rise and hum, oh how far they've come right. Maybe it was outside influences, maybe the band wanted to fit in with today's mainstream artists, or maybe it's because Skrillex worked on the album with them. Whatever it was, it wasn't for me. Although some tracks have grown on me over time, or maybe I just like Depeche Mode and Incubus ripped them off. I have forgotten what it tastes like. more and more the band seemed to be making a joke out of their music. Like, let's just put this out for a laugh. Or maybe it was Incubus' subtle way of saying they were not just a one-genre band. I know I should've known better. Yeah, it's possible that they felt victimized after the brash assumption of Fairweather fans. I wasn't surprised, but I wasn't happy either. Then something happened. Incubus released Trust Fall Side B, and like a phoenix from the ashes, they rose back up. Incorporating sounds from their past and finding a comfortable balance between the playfulness and the beauty, the melodies had returned. Some tracks sound as though they were ripped straight out of the 90s, with that alt-rock sound front and center. Other songs seem like they're directly addressing the fans. You're right to be kind of bitter. That serenade, you could say it was a car. Some could say this is Incubus coming full circle, using their own career as inspiration, looking backward and forward at the same time. From Fungus Among Us to Trust Fall Side B, maybe every song wasn't great, but the ones that were, and there's a lot of them, made a huge impact on my life. That's why in my mind, Incubus will always be legends.